Then he made this obscene gesture at me.
Cheeky little devil, wasn't he?
Yeah, can you imagine that?
Here it is, third article this week.
Wonderful.
Just listen to this. A source requesting to remain anonymous said that the merchants would make their payments to a bag man who would then split his take with his fellow detectives.
Somebody's got something. They ain't splitting it with me.
Total payments were estimated at over $170,000 annually.
How much is that divided by four?
How can a paper get away with printing those lies, Barn?
Freedom of the press, Wojo, comes under the umbrella of the First Amendment.
Yeah, well, what about bearing false witness against one's neighbor?
I said amendment. That's a commandment.
So?
Subtle difference, I agree. Look at that. One of the victims who refused to be identified said that the bribery kickback system involved various detectives in the 3rd,
12th,
27th, and 31st precinct.
Requesting to remain anonymous. I'd like to find that guy and rip out his vocal cords.
Cops taking bribes. Personally, I wouldn't care if the cops did take bribes.
Thank you.
I figure you got it coming. You guys are out there risking your lives, protecting us every day. So, if you need a little supplemental income, what's the harm?
Mm-hmm.
Nice coat.
Hmm? Oh, hey, thank you.
A gift.
John on a little lascivious, and he says to me, stereo is a big improvement over mono.
Take a pause out here.
Stereo is two. One on each side.
Oh, never mind, for crying out.
Lieutenant Scanlon.
Captain Miller.
Somehow I felt it in my bones that we'd be seeing you today.
Oh, this is going to be a special day, though, Captain. This is Mr. Sanders. Now, Mr. Sanders is a consultant to the department.
Mr. Sanders?
How do you do?
It's a tough question nowadays, Mr. Sanders.
Yeah. Well, as you know, Captain, I'm here to ask questions about certain allegations.
For want of a better word?
Yeah, you want a better word? I got a better word for you.
Scanlon, why don't you just get to it, huh?
What did I tell you about this guy, huh? Bottom line. Captain, with the help of Mr. Sanders, we're going to ask questions about you and your boys.
With the help of Mr. Sanders?
Go ahead, tell him.
Captain, my firm has developed a device that, with the proper execution, can measure a pattern of vocal stress in response to a set of prepared questions.
Oh, are you talking lie detector?
Lie detector?
You see, that's the first thing that jumps into people's minds.
Well, what is supposed to jump into my mind?
Captain, the device measures vocal stress. That's all.
You know what causes vocal stress, don't you? Guilty consciences? Am I getting warm? For
Proponents of these devices believe that there are certain audible microtremors in the voice. That under stress, these microtremors are said to flatten measurably, thereby indicating the possibility of a lie.
Precisely.
Critics, however, refer to this as so much sheep dip.
That's a lie.
Prove it.
Excuse me. Are we required to submit to this device?
Not if you think it might make you look bad, no.
You could take the fifth. Want to?
And why don't you just come ask us straight out?
Huh?
Harris, did you take any bribes?
No.
See? Harris doesn't lie. So you can take your machine and stick it up your internal affairs.
Sanders.
Wojo, Wojo, nothing for Wojo. Harris, it's a letter from the New Yorker.
Hey.
Rejection slip, I think.
How do you know?
The same envelope the others came in.
Very observant of you.
Oh, sir, I just want you to know, sir, that most of the uniforms in the building feel that what's being written about you detectives is a bunch of baloney.
Thank you, Levitt. Tell the men we appreciate it.
Betting shows you a 3-1 favorite for acquittal, sir. Hang in there. 3-1.
How'd it go?
It couldn't break me.
Come on.
Well, I mean, it was a little unsettling, but all you gotta do is stay calm.
Oh, God.
Won't you? I'm telling you, you do not have to go.
I'm gonna be all right, Barn. Don't worry.
Have a seat, please, Sergeant.
Go on, sit down. It's all right.
What am I supposed to do?
Well, first we're going to determine your stress pattern. I'm going to ask you a series of seemingly innocuous questions, and I want you to answer truthfully. So just try and relax. All right, Sergeant?
Okay.
All right. Is your name Wojowicz?
No.
Sergeant, would you...
What's all that noise about?
Try and relax. You appear to be very, very,
high-strung.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, my mother always says I'm high-strung.
Do you like your mother?
What kind of garbage is that?
Sergeant, this is only for testing.
Yeah, well, just leave my mother out of it.
I was only trying to...
Take it easy.
But go on, sit down.
Yeah, right. Got it. You're in luck, Mr. Rampson.
I am.
Barney, a patrol car recovered Mr. Rampson's vehicle with the furs and the suspect in it. I'll go pick him up.
Good.
I don't believe that.
There's a lot of that going around.
I mean, isn't it rare that somebody gets caught that fast?
Extremely rare, Mr. Rampson. You're a very lucky man.
Yeah. I'm almost blessed.
That damn machine is calling me a liar. First it said I didn't like my mother.
What?
Yeah, and then he starts beeping his buns off every time I say I'm not taking bribes.
Definite patterns.
I got a definite pattern for you and your machine. Anyway, I'm talking to my captain in his office. Come on.
Legally, this does not mean a thing.
It doesn't?
No. However, any results of any tests can be entered into any report simply because you volunteered to take the test.
But I didn't volunteer for anything.
I told you you didn't have to take
but
it.
But if I didn't take it, I'd look guilty.
That's called volunteering.
Barn,
If that goes on my record that I wasn't telling the truth, you know, that I'm a liar, that I can't be trusted, I've had it as a law enforcement officer.
That's true.
It is? I mean, I wasn't expecting you to agree with me.
You and me got unfinished business.
Seeking the truth?
Right on.
Scanlon.
It's all yours.
Soup sign.
Dietrich.
Yo.
You're up. But only if you consent.
I insist.
This one, you gotta watch.
All right, come on, get inside.
Hey, man, these are legs, not wheels.
That's him. That's the one who made the obscene gesture.
Yeah, and I'd do it again if I could get these cuffs off.
Pellegrini, cool.
Hey, I'm hostile to society. What do you expect?
What do we got here?
Mario Pellegrini. It's a self-proclaimed antisocial. This is Captain Miller.
Oh, another authoritarian figure. Pleased to meet you, big shot.
Oh, hey, he's tough. Mm-hmm. He doesn't intimidate. Rough customer.
And don't forget, stupid. He ran a red light and got caught with the car in the first.
Hey, I got convictions on my record like burglary, dealing drugs, assault with a deadly weapon. Mm. You expect me to obey the rules of the road?
Put this thing somewhere, will you?
Hey, Dillinger. In the chair. Come on.
Where do you want these? Anybody?
Take them downstairs. Put them in the trunk of my car.
Love it.
Put them on your mother's desk.
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry, Mr. Ramson, but these have to be held in evidence.
Yeah, Captain. I'm a small businessman. This is practically my whole inventory. I can't afford to lose the impulse sales.
Impulse sales?
Birthdays, anniversaries. An executive gets a secretary in trouble, it makes an excellent shower gift.
Official procedures, sir. Levitt, first thing we have to do is check it against the invoices.
Yeah, Captain, that's not necessary. Official procedures.
Exactly. Yeah, have a seat, Mr. Ramson.
These things are heavy.
Very heavy.
Must be rough on the little minks. All this stuff on their backs. I'll bet they're glad when they get it shaved off.
I want to tell him.
Your real name is?
Arthur P. Dietrich.
And the P stands for?
I was never told.
Where were you born, Sergeant?
It's hard to remember. It was long, long ago. In a galaxy. Far, far away. Hey, I'm only kidding.
I know you are. Yeah, that's the problem.
Let's get down to the filth. Now, let's forget about the middle names and the galaxy.
There are supposed to be some changes in the pulse.
Well, fix the damn thing.
Tell me something. Was there anything on your mind today that was particularly upsetting you? I mean, that might have caused this kind of results. No? Nothing more than usual. Such as?
Well, such as stuff I normally think about. You know, what am I gonna have for lunch? How's my mother getting along? Whether or not we're gonna have a nuclear war?
Sir? Yeah. It all checks out. $20,000 worth of hair. It's hard to imagine.
What the hell are you talking about?
Hey.
Look, I may be an O-class punk, but I got a sense of value. That stuff is junk.
You say, Mr. Ramson, Mr. Pellegrini seems to be an expert in these kind of things.
Thank you. The stuff is almost worthless. Mismatched skins, used material. Some of the stuff isn't even mink.
You're a liar!
Mr. Ramson?
Captain, he doesn't know what he's talking about.
There's no labels in these things, sir.
The labels go on last! I didn't even have time yet.
Mr. Ramson, did you call your insurance company yet?
Before I came in here, of course I did.
Well, do you think it's possible? Now, I'm just speculating, but do you think it's possible that you might have accidentally picked up the wrong invoices?
What? What are you talking about, wrong? Wrong invoices? I feel foolish.
I thought you would.
Oh, Captain.
A minute, Scanlon. Mr. Ramson, for some strange reason, the word fraud seems to pop into my head.
White-collar crime makes me sick.
Down, Billington.
Captain. I made a mistake. I made a simple, honest mistake.
You're in luck, Mr. Ramson. I mean, not that you're required to, but we happen to have in my office a little machine that measures...
Captain, I'm going to go down to my shop. I'm going to get you the right invoice right now.
You do that, Mr. Ramson. In the meantime, we'll call your insurance company just in case you happen to forget.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Gentlemen, did I mention my policeman and fireman's discount plan? Oh, yes, I did. Bye. Oh, Captain. It is time.
All right. Put the stuff in the property room.
Yes, sir. Sir, good luck. I got 20 on the nose. Yeah. Come on.
Let's get started.
Sorry to disappoint you, Scanlon.
I beg your pardon?
I am not volunteering to take this test.
You must be joking.
You seem to be missing the point, Scanlon. I never joke with you. I take you very, very seriously.
Hey, wait a minute. You don't want to take this test? It's all right with me. It will be duly noted, of course. Along with any kind of reason by way of explanation that you may want to enter into the records.
My reason?
Yeah.
The failure of Sergeant Wojciechowicz. You see, I know he's telling the truth. Ergo, the machine is inaccurate.
That's not true!
Sorry, Mr. Sanders. I know you put a lot of time and effort into this.
Time and effort? What about what about body and soul? Knowledge, sweat. What about love?
Don't you go weird on me, Sanders.
It doesn't work.
It works. Of course it works, and it works damn good.
Scanlon, you're not here because of any concrete evidence you may have against me or my men. You're here on a witch hunt.
Wait a minute. You accusing me of a personal vendetta or something?
You may not be fast, Scanlon, but you're accurate.
The only reason that I am here is because of specific charges against this squad. I mean, I am not here out of any personal distaste I may have for you or your men. You're shutting the hell up!
Apologize, Inspector. There does seem to be an argument for the accuracy of this machine.
Of course there is.
Well, wait a minute. Now, what in the hell are you trying to pull, Miller?
Nothing. It's just that, along with Sergeant Wojciechowicz's results, that last assessment by this machine will also go into the record. Picks up on malice aforethought, very discerning.
Oh, absolutely.
Now, just wait a minute.
One thing goes into the record, everything goes into the record.
right. It's all right with me.
Harris, you call?
Oh, right. Pictures and prints for Mr. Pellegrini.
My pleasure. This way, Pellegrini.
Hey, don't you want to handcuff me? I mean, what if I try to escape or something?
Levitt will just shoot you down like the others.
You kidding me?
Hey, talk about bitter. You are an amateur compared to that man.
Thanks, Harris.
You're welcome.
Let's go.
Gentlemen, Lieutenant Scanlon has a few words he would like to say to us. Lieutenant Scanlon, the floor is yours.
Yeah. Well, it appears that we have...
Would you speak up a little bit, please?
It appears that we have a problem with the machine. It isn't worth doodly squat. Functioning properly at this time.
Well, now, Lieutenant...
Isn't that right, Mr. Sanders?
I think it's possible...
That it's not functioning properly at this time.
And?
And that's all there is to that.
Excuse me, gentlemen. Lunch on me tomorrow. Move.
Lieutenant Scanlon, always a pleasure.
TKO Miller, it's not a knockout. I'll see you around. Oh, yeah. See you around.
Sergeant Dietrich. Something I just don't understand. When you were in there and you said you were born on another galaxy, the machine said you were telling the truth.
Well, if your theory is correct, perhaps it proves that the microtremors in the voice can be consciously controlled by some people.
Or you were telling the truth. That's ridiculous.
I was born October 23rd, 1947, St. Mary's Hospital, Allentown, Pennsylvania. Needed to be said.
Wheels.
That's him. That's the one who made the obscene gesture.
Yeah, and I'd do it again if I could get these
hey,
cuffs
look,
off.
Pellegrini, cool.
Hey, I'm hostile to society. What do you expect?
What do we got here?
Mario Pellegrini. It's a self-proclaimed antisocial. This is Captain Miller.
Oh, another authoritarian figure. Pleased to meet you, big shot.
Oh, hey, he's tough. Mm-hmm. He doesn't intimidate. Rough customer.
And don't forget stupid. He ran a red light and got caught with the car in the first.
Hey, I got convictions on my record like burglary, dealing drugs, assault with a deadly weapon. Mm. You expect me to obey the rules of the road?
Put this thing somewhere, will you?
Hey, Dillinger, in the chair. Come on.
Where do you want these? Anybody?
Take them downstairs. Put them in the trunk of my car.
Love it. Put them on your monitor's desk.
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry, Mr. Ramson, but these have to be held in evidence.
Yeah, Captain. I'm a small businessman. This is practically my whole inventory. I can't afford to lose the impulse sales.
Impulse sales?
Birthdays, anniversaries. An executive gets a secretary in trouble and makes an excellent shower gift.
Official procedures, sir. Levitt, first thing we have to do is check it against the invoices.
Captain, that's not necessary. Official procedures.
Exactly. Yeah, have a seat, Mr. Ramson.
These things are heavy.
Very heavy.
Must be rough on the little minks. All this stuff on their backs. I'll bet they're glad when they get it shaved off.
I want to tell him.
Your real name is?
Arthur P. Dietrich.
And the P stands for?
I was never told.
Where were you born, Sergeant?
It's hard to remember. It was long, long ago. In a galaxy. Far, far away. Hey, I'm only kidding.
I know you are. Yeah, that's the problem.
Let's get down to the filth. Now, let's forget about the middle names and the galaxy.
There are supposed to be some changes in the pulse.
Well, fix the damn thing.
Tell me something. Was there anything on your mind today that was particularly upsetting you? I mean, that might have caused this kind of results.
No? Nothing more than usual.
Such as?
Well, such as stuff I normally think about. You know, what am I gonna have for lunch? How's my mother getting along? Whether or not we're going to have a nuclear war.
Sir? Yeah. It all checks out. 20,000 bucks worth of hair. It's hard to imagine.
What the hell are you talking about?
Hey.
Look, I may be an O-class punk, but I got a sense of value. That stuff is junk.
What do you say, Mr. Ramson? Mr. Pellegrini seems to be an expert in these kind of things.
Thank you. The stuff is almost worthless. Mismatched skins, used material. Some of the stuff isn't even mink.
You're a liar!
Ramson?
No, I'm going to be all right, Barn. Don't worry.
Have a seat, please, Sergeant.
Go on, sit down. It's all right.
What am I supposed to do?
Well, first we're going to determine your stress pattern. I'm going to ask you a series of seemingly innocuous questions, and I want you to answer truthfully. So just try and relax. All right, Sergeant?
Okay.
All right. Is your name Wojewicz?
No.
Sergeant, would you...
What's all that noise about?
Try and relax. You appear to be very, very,
Am I strong? Mm-hmm. Yeah, my mother always says I'm high strung.
Do you like your mother?
What kind of garbage is that?
Sergeant, this is only for testing.
Yeah, well, just leave my mother out of it.
I was only trying to...
Take it easy.
But go on, sit down.
Yeah, right. Got it. You're in luck, Mr. Ramson.
I am.
Barney, patrol car recovered Mr. Ramson's vehicle with the furs and the suspect in it. I'll go pick him up.
Good. I don't believe that.
There's a lot of that going around.
I mean,
isn't it rare that somebody gets caught that fast?
Extremely rare, Mr. Ramson. You're a very lucky man.
Yeah. I'm almost blessed.
That damn machine is calling me a liar. First it said I didn't like my mother. Yeah, and then he starts beeping his buns off every time I say I'm not taking bribes.
A definite pattern.
I got a definite pattern for you and your machine. Anyway, I'm talking to my captain in his office. Come on.
Legally, this does not mean a thing.
It doesn't?
No. However, any results of any tests can be entered into any report simply because you volunteered to take the test.
But I didn't volunteer for anything.
I told you you didn't have to take
but
it.
But if I didn't take it, I'd look guilty.
That's called volunteering.
Barn. If that goes on my record that I wasn't telling the truth, you know, that I'm a liar, that I can't be trusted, I've had it as a law enforcement officer.
That's true.
It is? I mean, I wasn't expecting you to agree with me.
You and me got unfinished business.
Seeking the truth?
Right on.
Scanlon.
It's all yours.
Soup sign.
Dietrich.
Yo.
You're up. But only if you consent.
I insist.
This one, you gotta watch.
All right, come on, get inside.
Hey, man, these are...
Captain, he doesn't know what he's talking about.
There's no labels in these things, sir.
The labels go on last. I didn't even have time yet.
Mr. Ramson, did you call your insurance company yet?
Before I came in here, of course I did.
Well, do you think it's possible? No, I'm just... speculating, but you think it's possible that you might have accidentally picked up the wrong invoices?
What?
What are you talking about, wrong invoices?
I feel foolish.
I thought you would.
Oh, Captain.
Wait a minute, Scanlon. Mr. Ramson, for some strange reason, the word fraud seems to pop into my head.
White-collar crime makes me sick. Down.
Dylan Tiffin.
Captain.
I made a simple, honest mistake.
You're in luck, Mr. Ramson. I mean, not that you're required to, but we happen to have in my office a little machine that measures...
Captain, I'm going to go down to my shop. I'm going to get you the right invoice right now.
You do that, Mr. Ramson. In the meantime, we'll call your insurance company just in case you happen to forget.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Gentlemen, did I mention my policeman and fireman's discount plan? Oh, yes, I did. Bye.
Oh, Captain. It is time.
All right. Put the stuff in the property room.
Yes, sir. Sir, good luck. I got 20 on the nose.
Let's get started.
Sorry to disappoint you, Scanlon.
I beg your pardon?
I am not volunteering to take this test.
You must be joking.
You seem to be missing the point, Scanlon. I never joke with you. I take you very, very seriously.
Hey, wait a minute. You don't want to take this test? It's all right with me. It will be duly noted, of course. Along with any kind of reason by way of explanation that you may want to enter into the records.
My reason?
Yeah.
The failure of Sergeant Roger Howitz. You see, I know he's telling the truth. Ergo, the machine is inaccurate.
That's not true!
Sorry, Mr. Sanders. I know you put a lot of time and effort into this.
Time and effort? What about what about body and soul, knowledge, sweat? What about love?
Don't you go weird on me, Sanders.
It doesn't work.
It works.
Of course it works, and it works damn good.
Scanlon, you're not here because of any concrete evidence you may have against me or my men. You're here on a witch hunt.
Wait a minute. You accusing me of a personal vendetta or something?
You may not be fast, Scanlon, but you're accurate.
The only reason that I am here is because of specific charges against this squad. I mean, I am not here out of any personal distaste I may have for you or your men.
Come on, orphans, I gave you all the information
Ramson,
already.
Mr. Ramson, I need the license plate number on the stolen vehicle.
Ramson number one.
All right. You got two cars?
No. Number one stands for me.
I see.
Listen, I don't care about the car. I care about the $20,000 worth of beautiful furs inside.
Yeah, I understand. You were in the back of the shop at the time. Right?
Yes, and I carried the furs out of the back, put them in the back of the car, went back inside to get my invoices. I come out, and the guy's jumping into my car and pulls away.
You got a good look at him?
You're damn right. I started screaming at him, "Stop, thief! Get out of my car!" Like that.
He didn't stop, huh?
No, he just drove away. And then he made this obscene gesture at me.
Cheeky little devil, wasn't he?
Yeah, can you imagine that?
Here it is, third article this week.
Wonderful.
Just listen to this. A source requesting to remain anonymous said that the merchants would make their payments to a bag man who would then split his take with his fellow detectives.
Oh. Somebody's got something, they ain't splitting it with me.
Total payments were estimated at over $170,000 annually.
How much is that divided by four?
How can a paper get away with printing those lies, Barn?
Freedom of the press, Wojo, comes under the umbrella of the First Amendment.
Yeah, well, what about bearing false witness against one's neighbor?
I said amendment. That's a commandment.
So?
Subtle difference, I agree. Yeah, look at that. One of the victims who refused to be identified said that the bribery kickback system involved various detectives in the 3rd,
12th,
27th, and 31st precinct.
Requesting to remain anonymous. I'd like to find that guy and rip out his vocal cords.
Cops taking bribes. Personally, I wouldn't care if the cops did take bribes.
Thank you.
I figure you got it coming. You guys are out there risking your lives, protecting us every day. So, if you need a little supplemental income, what's the harm?
Mm-hmm.
Nice coat.
Hmm? Oh, hey, thank you.
A gift.
John on a lewd lascivious, and he says to me, stereo is a big improvement over mono.
Take a pause out here. Stereo is two. One on each side. Oh, never mind for crying out.
Lieutenant Scanlon.
Captain Miller.
Somehow I felt it in my bones that we'd be seeing you today.
Oh, this is going to be a special day, though, Captain. This is Mr. Sanders. Now, Mr. Sanders is a consultant to the department.
Mr. Sanders?
How do you do?
It's a tough question nowadays, Mr. Sanders.
Yeah. Well, as you know, Captain, I'm here to ask questions about certain allegations.
For want of a better word?
Yeah, you want a better word? I got a better word for you.
Scanlon, why don't you just get to it, huh?
What did I tell you about this guy, huh? Bottom line. Captain, with the help of Mr. Sanders, we're going to ask questions about you and your boys.
With the help of Mr. Sanders?
Go ahead, tell him.
Captain, my firm has developed a device that, with the proper execution, can measure a pattern of vocal stress in response to a set of prepared questions.
Oh, are you talking lie detector?
Lie detector?
You see, that's the first thing that jumps into people's minds.
Well, what is supposed to jump into my mind?
Captain, the device measures vocal stress. That's all.
You know what causes vocal stress, don't you? Guilty consciences. Am I getting warm?
Proponents of these devices believe that there are certain audible microtremors in the voice. That under stress, these microtremors are said to flatten measurably, thereby indicating the possibility of a lie.
Precisely.
Critics, however, refer to this as so much sheep dip.
That's a lie.
Prove it.
Excuse me. Are we required to submit to this device?
Not if you think it might make you look bad, no.
You could take the fifth. Want to?
And why don't you just come ask us straight out?
Huh?
Harris, did you take any bribes?
No.
See? Harris doesn't lie. So you can take your machine and stick it up your internal affairs.
Sanders.
Wojo, Wojo, nothing for Wojo. Harris, it's a letter from the New Yorker.
Hey.
Rejection slip, I think.
How do you know?
The same envelope the others came in.
Very observant of you.
Oh, sir, I just want you to know, sir, that most of the uniforms in the building feel that what's being written about you detectives is a bunch of baloney.
Thank you, Levitt. Tell the men we appreciate it.
Betting shows you a 3-1 favorite for acquittal, sir. Hang in there. 3-1.
How'd it go?
It couldn't break me.
Come on.
Why? I mean, it was a little unsettling, but all you gotta do is stay calm.
Oh, God.
Won't you? I'm telling you, you do.
Come on, officer. I gave you all
Mr.
the information
Ramson,
already.
Mr. Ramson, I need the license plate number on the stolen vehicle.
Ramson number one.
All right. You got two cars?
No. Number one stands for me.
I see.
Listen, I don't care about the car. I care about the $20,000 worth of beautiful furs inside.
Yeah, I understand. You were in the back of the shop at the time.
Right? Yes, and I carried the furs out of the back, put them in the back of the car, went back inside to get my invoices. I come out, and the guy's jumping into my car and pulls away.
You got a good look at him?
You're damn right. I started screaming at him, "Stop, thief! Get out of my car!" Like that.
He didn't stop, huh?
No, he just drove away. And then he made this obscene gesture at me.
Cheeky little devil, wasn't he?
Yeah, can you imagine that?
Here it is, third article this week.
Wonderful.
Just listen to this. A source requesting to remain anonymous said that the merchants would make their payments to a bag man who would then split his take with his fellow detectives.
Oh. Somebody's got something. They ain't splitting it with me.
Total payments were estimated at over $170,000 annually.
How much is that divided by four?
How can a paper get away with printing those lies, Barn?
Freedom of the press, Wojo, comes under the umbrella of the First Amendment.
Yeah, well, what about bearing false witness against one's neighbor?
I said amendment. That's a commandment.
So?
Subtle difference, I agree.
Look at that. One of the victims who refused to be identified said that the bribery kickback system involved various detectives in the 3rd,
12th,
27th, and 31st precinct.
Requesting to remain anonymous. I'd like to find that guy and rip out his vocal cords.
Cops taking bribes. Personally, I wouldn't care if the cops did take bribes.
Thank you.
I figure you got it coming. You guys are out there risking your lives, protecting us every day. So, if you need a little supplemental income, what's the harm?
Mm-hmm.
Nice coat.
Hmm? Oh, hey, thank you.
A gift.
John on a little lascivious, and he says to me, stereo is a big improvement over mono.
Tell your boss I'm here. Stereo is two. One on each side. Oh, never mind, you're crying out.
Lieutenant Scanlon.
Captain Miller.
Somehow I felt it in my bones that we'd be seeing you today.
Oh, this is going to be a special day, though, Captain. This is Mr. Sanders. Now, Mr. Sanders is a consultant to the department.
Mr. Sanders?
How do you do?
It's a tough question nowadays, Mr. Sanders.
Yeah. Well, as you know, Captain, I'm here to ask questions about certain allegations.
For want of a better word?
Yeah, you want a better word? I got a better word for you.
Scanlon, why don't you just get to it, huh?
What did I tell you about this guy, huh? Bottom line. Captain, with the help of Mr. Sanders, we're going to ask questions about you and your boys.
With the help of Mr. Sanders?
Go ahead, tell him.
Captain, my firm has developed a device that, with the proper execution, can measure a pattern of vocal stress in response to a set of prepared questions.
Oh, are you talking lie detector?
Lie detector?
You see, that's the first thing that jumps into people's minds.
Well, what is supposed to jump into my mind?
Captain, the device measures vocal stress. That's all.
You know what causes vocal stress, don't you? Guilty consciences? Am I getting warm?
Proponents of these devices believe that there are certain audible microtremors in the voice. that under stress, these microtremors are said to flatten measurably, thereby indicating the possibility of a lie.
Precisely.
Critics, however, refer to this as so much sheep dip.
That's a lie.
Prove it.
Excuse me. Are we required to submit to this device?
Not if you think it might make you look bad, no. You could take the fifth. Want to?
And why don't you just come ask us straight out?
Huh?
Harris, did you take any bribes?
No.
See? Harris doesn't lie. So you can take your machine and stick it up your internal affairs.
Sanders.
Wojo, Wojo, nothing for Wojo. Harris, it's a letter from the New Yorker.
Hey.
Rejection slip, I think.
How do you know?
The same envelope the others came in.
Very observant of you.
Oh, sir, I just want you to know, sir, that most of the uniforms in the building feel that what's being written about you detectives is a bunch of baloney.
Thank you, Levitt. Tell the men we appreciate it.
Betting shows you a 3-1 favorite for acquittal, sir. Hang in there. 3-1.
How'd it go? It couldn't break me.
Come on.
Why? I mean, it was a little unsettling, but all you gotta do is stay calm.
Oh, God.
Don't you? I'm telling you, you do not have to go.
No, I'll be all right, Barn. Don't worry.
Have a seat, please, Sergeant.
Go on, sit down. It's all right. What am I supposed to do?
Well, first we're going to determine your stress pattern. I'm going to ask you a series of seemingly innocuous questions, and I want you to answer truthfully. So just try and relax. All right, Sergeant?
Okay.
All right. Is your name Wojowicz?
No.
Sergeant, would you...
What's all that noise about?
Try and relax. You appear to be very, very,
high strung. Mm-hmm. Yeah, my mother always says I'm high strung.
Do you like your mother?
What kind of garbage is that?
Sergeant, this is only for testing.
Yeah, well, just leave my mother out of it.
I was only
trying
to...
Take it easy. Look, come on, sit down.
Yeah, right. Got it. You're in luck, Mr. Ramson.
I am.
Barney, a patrol car recovered Mr. Ramson's vehicle with the furs and the suspect in it. I'll go pick him up.
Good. I don't believe that.
There's a lot of that going around.
I mean, isn't it rare that somebody gets caught that fast?
Extremely rare, Mr. Ramson. You're a very lucky man.
Yeah. I'm almost blessed.
That damn machine is calling me a liar. First it said I didn't like my mother. Yeah, and then it starts beeping its buns off every time I say I'm not taking bribes.
Definite patterns.
I got a definite pattern for you and your machine. Anyway, I'm talking to my captain in his office. Come on.
Legally, this does not mean a thing.
It doesn't?
No. However, any results of any tests can be entered into any report simply because you volunteered to take the test.
But I didn't volunteer for anything.
I told you you didn't have to take it.
But if I didn't take it, I'd look guilty.
That's called volunteering.
Barn. If that goes on my record that I wasn't telling the truth,
You know that I'm a liar, that I can't be trusted? I've had it as a law enforcement officer.
That's true.
It is? I mean, I wasn't expecting you to agree with me.
You and me got unfinished business.
Seeking the truth?
Right on.
Scanlon.
It's all yours.
Soup, son.
Dietrich.
Yo.
You're up. But only if you consent.
I insist.
This one, you gotta watch.
All right, come on, get inside.
Hey, man, these are legs, not wheels.
That's him. That's the one who made the obscene gesture.
Yeah, and I'd do it again if I could get these cuffs off.
Hey, look, Pellegrini, cool.
Hey, I'm hostile to society. What do you expect?
What do we got here?
Mario Pellegrini. It's a self-proclaimed antisocial. This is Captain Miller.
Oh, another authoritarian figure. Pleased to meet you, big shot.
Oh, hey, he's tough. Mm-hmm. He doesn't intimidate. Rough customer.
And don't forget, stupid. He ran a red light and got caught with the car in the first.
Hey, I got convictions on my record like burglary, dealing drugs, assault with a deadly weapon. Mm. You expect me to obey the rules of the road?
Put this thing somewhere, will you?
Hey, Dillinger, in the chair. Come on.
Where do you want these? Anybody?
Take them downstairs. Put them in the trunk of my car.
Love it. Put them on your monitor's desk.
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry, Mr. Ramson, but these have to be held in evidence.
Yeah, Captain. I'm a small businessman. This is practically my whole inventory. I can't afford to lose the impulse sales.
Impulse sales?
Birthdays, anniversaries. An executive gets a secretary in trouble, it makes an excellent shower gift.
Official procedures, sir. Levitt, first thing we have to do is check it against the invoices.
Captain, that's not necessary.